Undisputed, we are live from Los Angeles. I'm Jenny Taft here with Skip Bayless, Shannon Sharp. Good morning, guys.
Good morning, Jenny.
Oh, here we go. Let's see if you can defend your man Floyd
Lawrence.
Now.
Lawrence did keep his name out your mouth.
Oh, did he?
Yeah, that was
mine, his name's gonna be all over my mouth today.
Yeah, he's talking to you.
Yeah, I think he might be, and that's fine.
On today's show, is Ezekiel Elliott really the most important cowboy? And is Zion Williamson already an NBA superstar? But let's start with a potential super fight. We may be getting closer to a Mayweather-Pacquiao rematch. Manny's trainer, Freddie Roach, was here on the show yesterday and said if they fight again and both guys are healthy, quote, Pacquiao takes him out. Floyd won by a unanimous decision when the two fought 4 years ago. And Floyd is not letting anyone forget it. Floyd posted on Instagram yesterday, I find it real ironic every time Pacquiao's name is brought up in the media, my name is always attached to it. This man's entire legacy and career has been built off its association with my name. 4 years, all you heard was that Floyd is afraid of Manny Pacquiao. But what's funny is when we finally fought, I won so easily that everyone had to eat their words. All of the so-called boxing experts, critics, and jealous American fan base either went mute and ran for cover or made every excuse in the world as to why I should give Manny Pacquiao a rematch. Ultimately, I will always have the last laugh. And then Manny responded on Twitter saying this, Floyd Mayweather, you come to my fight and then use my name in a post, but I'm the one that is trying to stay relevant. Woo. You want to be relevant again, May Pac 2. Don't worry, guys. Floyd responded again with this, I make more money than you. I beat you. Then I signed you. I was only at your fight supervising you. My employee, as any real boss would do. I beat you mentally, physically, and financially. Remember, you fight because you have to. I fight when I want to.
Uh-huh.
And then this morning, another tweet.
Yeah, here we go.
We're still going, guys, from Manny. Excuse me, Floyd. Your name has not been on any of my PBC contracts. But if you would like to be on the next one, I will have one drawn up and sent to you. Counterfeit money.
Ooh.
Did you get all that? Did you hear anything there? They have been busy. Shannon, what did all of that tell you?
Manny want all that smoke, Mayweather. Skip, I still believe this fight's going to happen.
Mm.
If you remember last September, I think it was 2018, Mayweather posted on Instagram, he's coming back to fight Manny Pacquiao this year. Not going to happen this year. Another nine-figure payday. That's what he said.
He said it. And nothing happened.
So, for me, Skip, and this is how you build a fight. I ain't fighting. I don't need you. The only way you stay relevant is by mentioning my name. And every time you mention my name, you become more relevant. Okay. Remember, that's how it started with Conor McGregor. Yada, yada, yada. And then it built momentum, momentum. And the next thing you know, it's a big, giant payday. Skip, I just believe it's going to be too much money for Floyd to walk away from. I believe it's going to have, you're going to have to guarantee him, at bare minimum, $250 million. That's the bare minimum that he'd be willing to sign his name on the dotted line. And once you start approaching $300 million, it gets really, really hard if you're in the business, if you're in a business, to walk away from $300 million. And I believe Floyd is going to seriously consider this, and I believe he is considering it, because I believe deep down that Floyd believes, even at the ripe age of 43, which he will be in February of 2020, he still believes he can beat Manny Pacquiao. Because he beat him so easily in his mind, he believes he beat him so easily. Well, even if he's Floyd believes that Manny was healthy. We had Freddie Roach on yesterday. You mentioned it. Floyd tore his rotator cuff. And Freddie Roach said yesterday that by the fourth round, he said, I just can't throw any more punches.
He can't throw his right hand.
He can't throw his right hand. It just hurts too bad.
And by the way, did he throw his right hand against Keith Thurman the other night?
The
he
jab.
Knocked him down in the first round. Go ahead.
And so Manny clearly wants this fight. I believe this is the only reason that Manny is continuing the fight. And he knows in order to lure, that's what he's going to have to do, to lure Floyd out of retirement, he's going to have to look awfully impressive. And he's looked really impressive. He knocked out Matisse, and he gave Thurman his first, hung his first loss on Keith Thurman. So he knows, Skip, what he must do in order to lure Floyd out of retirement. And the way you do that is that you get the fans clamoring. Because I still believe, Skip, and everybody's like, I ain't watching, just like they said the first fight. I'm not watching it. I believe you, and you got about 5 TVs, and you will buy it on every last TV because you, along with a lot of other people, want to see Floyd go 50-1. Mm-hmm. That's what you want to see. Mm-hmm. That's the only reason people want to.
I want to see him go down.
That's a shame. Well, it's not going to happen. Mm-hmm. Even if the fight does happen, and I believe it will, I believe there's an 80% chance. We're going to talk about that maybe later.
Yep.
I believe Floyd is going to win again and going to walk away with $300 more million.
He will walk away with $300 more million and one big loss.
Nope.
That's what he will. It will be 50-1.
That's what you want.
Are you willing? Are you willing, Floyd? Do you dare risk getting your ass kicked by Manny Pacquiao?
Whoa!
I'm sorry. I'm sorry. It is coming.
No, it's not.
And last night, I don't think that was just a bunch of fight hype talk back and forth on social media. I think it got pretty real last night because I believe that Manny's response tweet to Floyd's first IG post caught Floyd flush in the jaw and knocked him right on his tiny little tail.
Okay.
That's what I think happened.
Okay, tiny little legs.
Tiny little legs. Remember Conor McGregor?
Yes.
That was maybe the highlight of the pre-fight night. So the Manny tweet was the response tweet. You come to my fight, which Floyd did on Saturday night. I was there. I saw Floyd, saw number two. It was quite a night. Mm-hmm. You come to my fight and then use my name in a post, but I'm the one that is trying to stay relevant, Floyd. If you want to be relevant again, then hashtag MayPack2. I think we need to flip that hashtag around to PackMay2. That's what I think.
No.
PackMay.
No.
Even though I'm sure Floyd can argue he will be the A side once
again.
Even though I'm sure Floyd will argue it should be 60-40, maybe even 70-30 Floyd on the split of this purse. Mm-hmm. I still believe that the better fighter right here, right now, as we saw on full display on Saturday night, is Manny Pacquiao. Mm-hmm. So that sent Floyd spinning off into another IG retort.
Oh, yeah.
And this one was flailing. This one was weak and lame because he goes into this whole idea that because Al Haymon promoted the fight on Saturday night, and Al Haymon was Floyd's manager when Floyd was fighting, but he hasn't fought for what has it been now?
Two years.
2 years. Mm-hmm. That somehow that means that Floyd came to supervise Saturday night's fight because he's above Al Haymon on the flow chart. And that means that he is now Manny's boss, or that's what he was trying to present in his second IG post. And again, that indicated to me that Manny got him. Gotcha. Now, I will say this, just for the record, I don't think Manny actually tweets.
Yeah.
I do know his PR man from years and years named Fred Sternberg, and Fred's a smart, clever guy, and Manny has never been a big trash talker, as we know. It's not his forte.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think, as Freddie Roach said yesterday, that it's in his heart to do that.
Right.
But again, he signs off at least on the fact that Fred can tweet for him whatever Fred wants to. So I think it came from Fred, just for the record.
Okay.
But it was funny, it was clever, and it was a gotcha.
Mm-hmm.
And here went Floyd, and then here came Manny slash Fred back again this morning with yet another one, daring Floyd to let's do it again.
And then he called a man hashtag counterfeit money.
Counterfeit money. Okay, so now let's go back to Floyd's first post that set off the fireworks last night, which was, I'll just read a couple lines. For years, all you heard was that, quote, Floyd is afraid of Manny Pacquiao, but I won so easily that everyone had to eat their words. This man knows no shame because he continues to gloat about the fact that he easily beat a one-armed fighter from whom he ran for 12 rounds.
Sure.
And again, we did have Freddie Roach on, and I'm going to reiterate what he said yesterday. You can take it or you can leave it.
Mm-hmm.
But Freddie has told me from the start that Manny tore his rotator cuff sparring 3 weeks ahead of that bout. Manny thought about trying to withdraw, but Manny does need the money because he gives his money away. That's what Freddie said yesterday.
Right.
Floyd spins, Manny gives away.
Mm-hmm.
And he gives away maybe way too much money in his native Philippines to the point that he's always a little bit on the edge.
Mm-hmm.
I need another fight. And I believe he's a desperate 40-year-old fighter trying to hold off Father Time because he doesn't want his boxing pipeline to dry up. And if he could fight until he's 50 or 60, he will try.
Or get one more, or maybe two more big paydays.
Maybe two, to your point. Yeah.
Because your Freddie said it also, Skip, he believed that if this fight were to happen, two fights will be in this contract.
He said it would be drawn up for
two
fights.
Yes. Okay.
Well, I don't know. Does Floyd want to dare the devil on that by presenting the possibility of a second fight? Because I don't think he can beat Manny right now. But again, back to the first fight. Mm-hmm. Freddie's point was that they both filed paperwork, Floyd and Manny, before the fight, May 2nd, 2015, mm-hmm. in Las Vegas, Floyd's town. They both filed paperwork with Nevada Athletic Commission to get painkilling injections. You have to declare it before.